Welcome back. In this video, I will discuss about numerical methods for solving ODE-based models. We'll start with Euler's method, the simplest and the oldest method. Suppose a ODE given to us is dx dt equal to function of x and t. I can do approximation and write dx dt is almost equivalent to del x by del t. I can further expand del x into x at t plus delta t minus x at t. So if I rearrange terms now, I can write x at t plus delta t is equal to x at t plus dx dt into delta t. Now this dx dt I can replace with my function in the ODE. So if I rewrite, I get this relationship. This equation is at the heart of solving ODEs using Euler's method. Let me try this equation for solving a ODE. This is our old model of spread of infection. Let us use Euler's method to solve it numerically. Using the equations for Euler's method, I can write x at t plus delta t is equal to x at t into the function that I have got from the ODE into delta t. To numerically solve this problem, you have to give me the numerical value of r and delta t, the parameter and the value of the delta t. Suppose r is 0.5, delta t is 0.1. You have to also specify the initial condition. Let at t equal to 0, x is equal to 0.02. Now create a table. The first column is time, second column is the dependent variable x, third column is del x, which is equal to the function of the ODE rx into 1 minus x into del t, and the last column is x plus del x. At t equal to 0, x is 0.02. So let me calculate del x for this value of x at time t equal to 0. This will be r, r is 0.5 into x is 0.02 into 1 minus x, that is 1 minus 0.02 into delta t, delta t is 0.1. I have done the calculation. It comes down to 0.00098. Let me put that value here in this cell. Now fill this column for x plus del x with the summation of the x and del x. I get so we are done in the first step of Euler's method. Now in the next step, t will be 0 plus del t, that is equal to 0 plus 0.1, that is equal to 0.1. Now x here would be this value, so we write down it here. Now we have to again calculate del x for this value of x. I have done the calculation and that is 0.001027. Now I will sum x and del x. By summing I get 0.22007. This way you can keep on calculating for different values of t until you reach the final time point. Suppose the final time point is 20 and you have got some value of x here, and you are done with the numerical solution of your ODE for that time period. Here I have plotted the data that I have got from numerical solution of the ODE by Euler's method. The blue line is the result that I have got using Euler's method with del t equal to 0.1. I have compared this result with the analytical result. Remember, the function that I get by integrating the ODE is the exact solution of my ODE. So the function that I get by integrating the ODE is this one. Now I can replace this value of x naught and replace the value of r, and then I plot it. Here this yellow line shows me the analytical solution or the exact solution. You can see the exact solution coming out of analytical method is almost same with the result that I have got for Euler's method. But it will not be same always. I'll show there is a trouble. But before I move into that, why don't you try yourself to use Euler's method? I have written down the ODE, given you the numerical value of initial condition and the parameter and del t. Use Euler's method to calculate the value of x at t equal to 0.3. Hope you are done with the calculation. I have repeated my calculation for the given ODE using Euler's method, but now with a bigger delta t, delta t equal to 1. The data is shown in this red line. You can see my Euler's method result has deviated quite a bit from the exact result or the analytical method. To understand the problems in my Euler's method, let me explain Euler's method graphically. This blue line represents a function x equal to ft. Suppose at t equal to 0 or initial time point, I am here at t, the value of x is xt. And I want to calculate the value of x at t plus delta t using Euler's method. The exact value or the correct value is this green dot, that is x at t plus delta t. In Euler's method, what I am doing, I am drawing a tangent at this initial position with a slope which is equal to the derivative of x at that position. Then I am following that tangent and reaching t plus delta t, and I am reaching the x which is shown by this red dot. The value of x there is x prime. So this x prime is my calculated value of x at t plus delta t using the Euler's method. You can easily see there is a difference between the exact value and the calculated one. That is the error in my calculation. How can I reduce it? I can reduce it by two ways. One, if I use a different line with a different slope, I may actually reach closer to the right result. So I need a different slope. The second option you can use is that reduce the size of delta t. Suppose I reduce the size of delta t, then I will be doing calculations here, and then you can see my calculated value and the real value are very close to each other. That means I have to reduce or make delta t smaller. We'll explore this slope issue first. There is a family of methods for solving ODEs numerically. These are called Runge-Kutta methods. These methods relies on Taylor series expansion. By Taylor series expansion, I can write x at t plus delta t is equal to x at t plus the first derivative of x into delta t, second derivative of x into delta t square by factorial 2 plus the third derivative of x into t delta t to the power 3 divided by the factorial of 3, and so on. You must have noticed if I take up to the first derivative part of Taylor series, this is nothing but equal to the equation that we were using in Euler's method. Runge-Kutta methods goes beyond this. The members of this methods family use other higher orders derivatives. So for example, Runge-Kutta method of fourth order, we'll take up to this fourth derivative and calculate a weighted average slope, and that slope will be used to calculate the value of x at the next time point. In this way, Runge-Kutta method gives us much more accurate result than Euler's method. Although these methods are almost 100 years old, these methods are regularly used by all of us. However, Runge-Kutta method does not resolve the issue of time step size. I have said that if you have smaller delta t, your error in calculation will be less. But when you reduce delta t, the computation time of the problem increases. How can you keep a balance between your accuracy of result as well as time of computation? Let us understand that graphically. Suppose this one is a function of t, x equal to a function of t. I want to solve this ODE to get this function using a numerical method. You must have noticed in this lower part of the function is increasing very slowly, it is shallow, whereas in this part, it is increasing very fast. Now, in Euler's method or in Runge-Kutta method, we are using a fixed delta t. So let us use fixed delta t and see the effect of that. So I have used delta t in both part. In the shallow part, this yellow color is the exact result, whereas the red one is the calculated one, calculated by my numerical method. You can see the difference between the exact result and the calculated one is very small. I have used the same delta t, but now in this fast moving zone, sharp zone of the function. Here, this is the exact result or the real one, real value of x. This one is my calculated one. So you can see there is a big error between the calculated one and the exact one. That means in this zone where the function is changing very fast, in this region, I have to use a smaller delta t. But how can I know which delta t I will use in which part of the curve? If I already know the function, then only I can do that. But I do not know the function. Then how can I decide the value of delta t at different position? We will use adaptive time step approach. In this algorithm, first set the limits of your error. H max and H min are the tolerance value, highest value of error and the lowest value of error that you will tolerate. Decide upon your first delta t. Then you do the calculation using two methods. For example, method 1 can be Runge-Kutta method of order 4, and you use another method like Runge-Kutta method of order 5. Out of these two methods, the second one is more accurate. Calculate the value of x at t plus delta t using both the method. So suppose in the RK4 Runge-Kutta fourth order method, the result is x1, and in the more accurate Runge-Kutta method of order 5, the result is x2. Now calculate the absolute error, which is nothing but difference between x2 and x1. If this error is bigger than h max, that is the highest value of error that you will tolerate, that means these two methods are giving completely different results. So I will reduce delta t, half delta t, and go back to your initial calculation. Calculate x at t plus delta t again using the same two methods. Calculate error again and check whether the error is bigger or smaller than h max. Suppose now e has become smaller than h max. Check whether the error is smaller than h mean or not. This is the lower level, lower tolerance limit that you will tolerate in error. So if the error is less than h mean, that means your delta t is much smaller than what is required. You accept the result obtained by the second method, that the accurate method, more accurate method. Update your clock by t plus delta t. Go back here and do the calculation for the next time step using a bigger delta t. That is delta t equal to 2 into delta t. Suppose the error is not smaller than h mean, but it is between h mean and h max. That means your delta t is fine. So you update your result. You take the result obtained by the second more accurate method and update the clock by t plus delta t. Go back to your calculation. Do the calculation again for the next time step using the same delta t. In this way, you are changing delta t depending upon the difference between two methods. Your belief is when two methods are giving almost close result, that means my delta t is fine. If results of two methods are deviating further, that means my delta t is bigger, I have to reduce it. In this way, you are judiciously changing delta t. This as a whole increases accuracy of your calculation without costing too much in computation time. Let me jot down the key points. Numerical methods are approximate, but remember they are powerful alternative to analytical or exact method of solving ODEs. For most problems in biology, we will use numerical methods. The key concept of any numerical method is to do a linear extrapolation using a slope at a particular point to calculate the value of x at the next time point. The simplest method is Euler's method. However, most of the time we use different methods of Runge-Kutta family, which are much better in numerical solutions of ODE. All modern algorithms use some sort of adaptive time step to increase the accuracy. That's all for this video. See you in the next one.